Hey guys, Courtney Cole. Thanks so much for swinging by my channel. Today we're going to talk quickly about the service that I offer for a neutral consent, a refusal, administrative process that that is done on a summons. And typically when you receive a summons, you know, in the mail, you have to return it. You have to refuse it and you have to send it back. If you keep that summons, that basically means that you automatically accept everything that's in that summons. They're going to hold you accountable. Nobody tells you this, guys, and you have got to really, you know, do your homework and research this stuff. But that is with any kind of correspondence in the mail that you receive, debt collector letters, anything like that. But here we're to talk about the summons. In a couple of videos, I have a victory as far as when I refused the summons, what happened. And what happened was is the judge dismissed the case, and I do post the actual letter from the judge saying that she dismissed it with prejudice, which means that the case was dismissed and can never be brought into the courts again, okay? So that is what happened with that. Also, I have testimonials on my website, ColesCreditRepair.ws, from other clients as well. So we know that it works. Okay, we know that it works, but guys, don't keep the summons and wait for the court date. Go into court, step in to do business, and get screwed, because that's exactly what's going to happen. And I don't care if you have an attorney or not. An attorney means a torrent. That means to give up your rights. They work for the government. They're there to screw you. Trust me, they're not there to protect you. And you guys got to do your homework on that as well. But I do explain a little bit as far as what the writing that you put on the summons at a 45-degree angle. I do mention a couple of sentences that need to be put on there. In the information below here, I have posted the link so you can watch it. But I have come across some people that are half-assing the process, and without having to purchase my service, they're going ahead and writing just what I say on there, and they're having it notarized and they're signing it. Having it notarized and then hand delivering it. It's like, guys, what are you doing? You know, I'm sure your debt is more than the $199 that I charged for this service. Guys, it's well worth it. Let me tell you why. Signature equals consent, guys. When you sign anything in regards to something that you're refusing, that you're reserving your rights, that you don't accept their offer, you don't sign it. You don't return it with your address on it. You don't physically go hand deliver your refusal. Guys, let me tell you, a lot of you watching have used, have purchased packages from me, have done services with me before. You have got to follow my instructions to the T, and it's so important that that you do, because if you miss one thing, you're going to get screwed. Okay, you're going to get in trouble. You're going to get your remedy refused. I mean, I can't stress enough here, but guys, don't sit there and do a couple sentences on the summons that I mentioned in the video and send it along. There's a whole process for that. It's very simple. A few things that you put on this summons. It takes 5 minutes to fill it out and mail it. And it takes 2 seconds to get the information from me. Yes, it's going to cost money. The reason why it costs money is because, you know, it's going to wipe your debt out. It's, you know, it's going to basically keep you from being on the docket, you know, keep you from going to court. I mean, isn't it worth a couple hundred dollars? And, you know, I know that you guys have paid for information. This information that I give you is very, very hard to find. It's very hard to find. I also offer the administrative process to actually walk you through it. I give you instructions verbatim how to refuse a summons. It's called a neutral consent, which is what you're doing is you're refusing it back to the person who sent it to you, which is going to be the courts, okay? And then you're going to copy over to the attorney your refusal. Let them know that you don't agree with what they're saying on there. If you don't stand up for your rights and you keep that summons, they're going to assume that you accept everything in that summons. and then hold you liable for it. Okay? That is why it's so important to contact me to get this information in your hands. This is something that you can literally use over and over and over and over again on debt collector letters, court correspondence, government correspondence, stuff from the IRS. I mean, it is unlimited what you can use this one process for forever. You're welcome to share it with your friends and family. It's copyrighted. Please do not sell it. But guys, well worth the investment. Okay, don't half-ass the stuff that I'm telling you, you know, on these videos, and just take a little bit of what I say and run with it, because it's not going to work. If I offer it as a service, you got to contact me and find out exactly what it is. And I, like I said, I get a lot of people basically just saying, can you tell me the rest of what you're writing on there? Guys, I spent years and years of research, all right, how to do these things. Knowledge is power. I'm self-taught. Everything that I have been doing thus far is information that I have learned on my own. And you guys have got to respect that. And you know what? You're going to pay for it. You know, you're going to pay for my knowledge to get your remedy. And that is just the bottom line. I get some little comments and things in my videos with people saying, you know, I'm not going to pay for, you know, for something that's just information. I mean, I'm sorry, but I know that you've purchased information before. There's packages all over the internet for information that will help you along to get where you need to go. If you do not, you know, step out of the box and get the information that you need to solve your problem, you're going to stay in that problem. You're going to have the same results. It's going to get worse. It's not going to get better. That debt is not going to go away unless you get the information that you need to help you deal with it to make it go away. Okay? So, anyway, in regards to refusing a summons, court document, you need to contact me at colescreditrepair@gmail.com. The best thing to do is, as soon as you receive it, if you can, you've got to return it within 3 days. You have to return it within 72 hours. Everything is a 3-day rule. Why it is that way, you're going to have to do your research about it. But guys, you know, contact me. Time is of essence. If you received a summons, definitely get a hold of me and I'll tell you exactly what you need to do. And that will definitely, you know, keep you away from the court. Now, if for some reason, you know, it's been longer than 3 days, you can still do the refusal, but there'll be a 50-50 chance on staying out of court. So anyway, with that said, you guys have a great day and stay tuned for the next video. Thanks so much.